motivational speaker for kids, and much more, has created something special that we want to share with you.
Yeah, I've gotten to know Kevin. His name is Kevin Zuala, but he goes by the name Mr. Peace for his performances. And he came up
with this is so cool. Kevin Zuala, a.k.a. Mr. Peace, joins us now. And what's so fun is that you do this. I mean, this is one of the things that you do, along with speaking to kids. So it's good to have you on the show.
Thank you so much for having me. Yes.
What was the inspiration outside of the obvious? When you see my face, you think super rap.
Yeah. Well, I get all my hip-hop skills from Chuck.
Right.
And it was just something that I'm passionate about this city.
Yeah.
And it's something that I just, you know, wanted to highlight what's going on, not only on this show, but just in general.
Yeah.
So it was just inspiration from that angle.
That's great. Yeah. So you are a graduate of U of M, and you have a master's from Wayne State.
Correct.
How did you start rapping? I know Chucky G, or Chuck G, as I call him, was an inspiration to you, but what made you be like, yeah, I want to rap?
Right. So I finished my MBA from Wayne State in 2010, and I was in the auto industry for about 5 years, and I made the leap of faith. So after 5 years in corporate America, I decided to leave to go after my greater passion, which is our youth. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I know that hip hop is something that they can relate to.
Mm-hmm.
So doing all this poetry and Weird Al Yankovic being a big inspiration when I was growing up about writing my own parodies, I ended up kind of putting the poetry to a beat.
Uh-huh.
And that's how the rap started.
All right, so what's your message to kids?
So the main message is that bullying, we know, is something that has to happen over and over and over again on purpose to get power over somebody.
Mm-hmm.
But the things that aren't bullying, like the one-time action or the one-time word, something that just takes 2 seconds can still hurt somebody forever.
Sure.
So my main message is that hurt people,
mm-hmm.
and that's a choice.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also a choice that healed people heal people.
Okay.
Yeah. So what are the cups about? Because this is part of your visual
demonstration. So what I always tell people, you know, like our heart, which is as big as our fist, right? I tell people to pretend that our heart is like this empty cup. And when we're born, we're free of pain. But little by little, this cup, which is our heart, it starts to get full, right? And we have painful memories, and people tell us that we're not good enough or that we're worthless, whatever it is, right? So it kind of becomes cloudy and dark.
Mm-hmm.
But eventually, if we choose this, because there's always room for love if we let it, then the hurt people becomes healed people who heal people.
Oh, that's
very
cool.
Wow, I love it.
Yeah. Yeah. And the bracelets, you shared this with me before when we first met.
Yeah.
Are these all from kids?
Yeah, so I have thousands of these. I've only took one of the bags with me today, and I always put about 10 on before my assembly programs. It kind of becomes my armor, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because every bracelet that was given to me was given to me by a student that said, Mr. Peace, if you weren't here today, I wouldn't be here tomorrow.
Wow.
That's kind of how serious the bullying epidemic is getting.
Mm-hmm.
And so if I'm able to just share my heart in hopes to just touch a small piece of theirs, sometimes I have 20 minutes with them, sometimes a full hour, but every one of these students kind of let go of their pain through the tears, through the bracelets, and I kind of took that on, but then I said that they don't have to bear it anymore.
Right. So how are kids responding to you? Because, like, we were talking about bullying yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
I was bullied as a kid, but today it's 10 times, 100 times worse than it was before. So how do kids respond?
Well, the biggest thing that I show them, right, is my heart, that I have to be real with them, because they're not going to respond if I'm not.
Right.
And I tell people, like I said, like the heart is as big as your fist, but the idea is that if you let love penetrate this, then this can turn into this.
Nice.
And I try to remind them too, you guys all have an M etched on your palms, right? Like the letter M, which stands for Michigan. No, I'm just joking. this letter M stands for someone that is truly a miracle.
Yeah.
And I kind of get a little choked up just talking about it, but upside down, it's worthy. And so if I can remind them, all these people out there, that they are miracles, right? And that they focus on that instead of all the negative comments and all the lies that come at them, right?
Yeah.
Then they're able to show the people love, which are the bullies, people that are screaming inside, that are hurting it in their hearts, and that we try to show them that, like, the opposite of what they expect, you know.
Well, you're a blessing to so many. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
And thank you for having fun with that hip-hop video for us, because it's going to get some other airplane. We
appreciate it.
Yeah.